Reserve is trying to pump the brakes on inflation, announcing an interest rate increase of 0.5%. That's less than previous hikes. Still, it's the 7th rate hike of the year.
Now, the modest increase is due in part to the Consumer Price Index report announced on Tuesday. It indicates inflation is now at 7.1% year over year. That's down 2 points from June. NBC News business and data reporter Brian Chung is at the Federal Reserve in Washington. Also with us is Investopedia editor-in-chief Caleb Silver. Brian, help us understand first what conditions the Fed had to look at here before making this modest rate increase.
Yeah, Aaron, as you mentioned, the Federal Reserve raising interest rates officially just a minute ago by 0.5 percentage point. All this because of high inflation. The Federal Reserve projecting that it could actually get inflation down 0.1% by the end of next year. That will be a pretty far drop from the number we just got yesterday in terms of the consumer price index showing prices 7.1% more expensive in November than they were that time of year. Last year, the Federal Reserve also projecting that the unemployment rate may rise as a result of its interest rate hikes, that the jobless rate could go up to 4.6% by the end of next year. That would be a pretty sharp increase from the 3.7% that we're at right now. Now, for what it's worth, markets right now are a bit mixed in response to this. We're taking a look at the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ currently down, but the Dow currently in the green. We'll have to see what the Fed chairman says in about 30 minutes when he takes the podium.
Caleb, let me go to you. Inflation is going down, but it's still a concern, obviously. What does this interest rate increase tell us about where inflation might be headed in the new year?
Yeah, it's going down. It's just going down super slowly. We still have high prices for food, high prices for shelter. The Federal Reserve wants inflation to be around 2%. As Ryan said, we're at 7.1%, pretty far gap, but they do project inflation at 3.1% next year. Consumers, on the other hand, expect inflation to remain around 5% next year, so another big disconnect there. But as these rates keep going up, inflation is slowing, albeit slowly.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today's top stories and breaking news by downloading the